Want macOS and Windows on one PC? Here's how to dual boot them step by step. First, create a bootable USB. Go to the browser and search for Olarla. Navigate to the Vanilla Images tab in this site. Scroll and find any macOS version to install. Here I'm selecting the latest macOS Sequoia. Follow the steps to download it from this site. Download it. These are files needed for the installation. I will provide the links in the description. Install CPU-Z software. Run it. Here you must notice the CPU code name and download EFI folder for your system. Now go back to the Olarla website and navigate to the EFI tab. Then download the correct EFI folder with the name of your CPU code name. My CPU code name is Tiger Lake. So I'm downloading the EFI folder for my system. After downloading the EFI folder, install Balina Etcher and run it. Click on Flash from File and select the macOS vanilla image you downloaded. Plug in your USB and select it. Use a 32 GB or larger drive for the latest macOS. Now, click Flash to start creating the bootable macOS USB. Install Mini Tool Partition Wizard and run it. Launch application. Find your USB drive from the list, right-click on the EFI partition, click on Hide Partition, right-click again and unhide the partition, then assign a letter to the drive. Click Apply to save the changes. Now, extract the EFI folder and the Explorer++ software. Open the folder and run Explorer++ as administrator. Go to Downloads, find the EFI folder, open it, and copy the folder. Go to the EFI partition, delete all its files. So you wanna go to war with me? You're talking like you think you're royalty. You think that I'm afraid, but I don't break. Then paste the copied EFI folder. You think I'll fall just like a guillotine. But I am here to stay, won't look away. Launch Mini Tool Partition Wizard. right-click on the drive where you want to install macOS. Click on Split. Allocate at least 50 GB for macOS and click OK. Apply the changes and restart your system. Enter BIOS by checking your PC's brand and using the corresponding BIOS key. Follow the text on the screen and change the BIOS settings accordingly. Disable fast boot. Disable secure boot. Change the boot order and set the bootable USB as the first option. Save the changes and exit BIOS. On boot, select Install macOS Sequoia to start the installation. This process can take some time, so be patient. Select your preferred language and open Disk Utility. Click View at the top and select Show All Devices. Select the drive partition where you want to install macOS. Erase the partition, give it a name, and select APFS format. Close Disk Utility after erasing the partition. Click on Install macOS Sequoia to proceed. Select your disk partition and click Continue to proceed with the installation. During macOS setup, create a user account by entering your name, username, and password. Accept the terms and conditions, etc. One last step before using macOS, setting it up to boot without the USB. Open the USB on the desktop, navigate to the files, and launch OpenCore Configurator. Click on the OpenCore Configurator icon in the top right corner. Mount both your USB's EFI folder and the EFI folder of the drive where macOS is installed. Then, copy the EFI folder from the USB partition and paste it into the macOS installed drive's EFI partition. Now, you can boot your system without the USB. That's it. You now have macOS and Windows running on your PC with dual boot. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tech content. See you in the next one.